Catch a vibe with Big Hass, only on Pulse. Pulse 95.
And we are going to say assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, peace, love and blessings, and welcome to another new episode of Catch a Vibe on Pulse 95 Radio. Big house with you guys. Catch a Vibe airs every Saturday and Sunday from 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. Catch a Vibe is Pulse's first and only music dedicated radio show. Catch a Vibe has been incredible. For me, I want to shout out all the singers, the songwriters, the musicians, the music activists, the poets that came through. Speaking to them has really rejuvenated me personally, and getting to know them on a personal level has been just incredible. Some of them I've chatted with them before on Yalla Home, for example, and some of them for the first time on Catch a Vibe. But the stories, our voices, our sound is being heard and being discussed in the best way possible, and for that I am so thankful. Today, and every time I'm introducing a guest, there's always a personal connection, because I'm a people's person, and I really, when I connect with somebody, I connect with them. And this human, this brother, first time I saw him was, I believe, in Dubai Design District. And I walked in, and he was saying a poem. And I was like, who is that? Because he captured my soul. It's like incredible. That was like about maybe four or five years ago. And he captured my soul in the best way possible. He's an incredible poet, an incredible spoken word poet, an amazing guitarist, and also a producer. He is actually a 2018 Rooftop Grand Slam champion. And if you know anything about Rooftop, you know that they're really a big stamp when it comes to poetry. And we've had him on the show on Yalla Home about 3 years ago. But the reason why I'm going to have him right now is because, like I said, he's an amazing human being. Good heart. And for me, this is what lasts. Ladies and gentlemen, the one, the only, Ziad Gadou. We're going to say assalamu alaikum.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Yeah,
so good to see you, man.
My brother.
So 3 years.
3 years.
طولت الغيبة.
I know. It's just crazy.
Look at my hair, bro. That's how long it's been.
I know, yeah. Guys, check out the old hair situation.
Yeah.
First of all, how you doing, man?
Alhamdulillah, man. زي ما بيقول العبود, الوضع ice coffee.
Okay. I like that. It's ice coffee. I love that. Ziad, you're from Egypt.
Yes, sir.
Masr Umm Dunya. You're obviously here in the UAE.
Yes, sir.
We want to get to know you. This is obviously a new show that means maybe new followers. Ziad, what was it about poetry that you got attracted to? How did you get into, like, you know, this incredible, you know, how did you discover this talent?
So I was lucky to have friends around me that cared about the fact that I wrote. I used to write a lot of descriptive, scenic writing that didn't have any purpose. بس بحب الكتابة. Like, I just, it's catharsis, you know? It kind of like deflates the thoughts.
I love that you said that, but how did that happen?
So that led to Safwa, shout out Safwa. She took me to Rooftop in 2013.
Shout out Safwa.
And I watched people tell their story in poems that were not quote unquote boring or predictable.
So wait, before 2013,
I had no idea it existed.
Really?
No idea. No clue.
Wow. So big shout out to Safwa.
يعني, she opened my, she was also the person that introduced me to Kendrick Lamar.
Like, oh, wait.
يعني, this person's very important.
Big round of applause for Safwa.
Because like at that point, my understanding of rap music was very like old school. But I didn't know that there was like a way to make rap very storytelling focused and engaging at the same time.
That's crazy.
But when I went to the open mic, I saw people really just talk about who they were. They were not performative.
Wow.
Imagine sitting and hearing someone perform about, I'm anxious today.
Yes, yes.
Here's why I think you should care about that. It's very grounding. Yeah.
Do you remember who you saw, like, back then?
First show, I think Farah Shamma was there.
No way.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Farah
Shamma. She did a piece in three languages.
Oh.
I can fully remember that. Obviously, Paul Dorian, shout out to him.
Shout out to Paul Dorian, of course. OG.
I can't remember if Salim Attas was there, but I'm pretty sure he was around.
Yeah.
Haytham Hayes. It's like a bunch of really old school.
2013? That's crazy.
Yes, sir.
So before 2013, Ziad Gadou.
No clue.
Didn't? Nothing.
Guitar. I was a guitarist.
Yes.
Since I was 12 years old.
Okay.
And that's all I did. I was just a guitarist. I stuck with bands. I performed in theater and that kind of thing. But spoken word gave my way of communicating a platform. I didn't know that
and
people listened.
Yeah.
I didn't know that people listened.
لا, you
know?
They listened heavily.
ما عرفتش إن في community. And then when I looked it up online, I found out, the في slam poetry competitions. ويلا بينا نحا هزبقك.
You see, you guys, it's impossible not to love him. It's impossible not to love this brother.
You know?
Just a couple of minutes in. And so I kind of want to press more on that.
Of course.
You went to this event. Mm-hmm. It inspired you to what? Start writing more?
It inspired me. I actually didn't do anything for a year.
Okay.
I was like, let me throw. And then I had a friend at the time, and he's like, let's just perform. You write all the time. Might as well just read it to people. Okay. طيب يلا بينا. What are you going to write about? I'm going to write about how anxious I am to perform.
Do you remember your first performance?
My first piece was about social anxiety, and I stuttered all through it because of how anxious I was.
When was that?
This was 2015, September.
Where?
Abu Dhabi, Fairmont, I think.
Wow.
Fairmont, Abu Dhabi, 2015, September. September 15, 2015.
And you spoke about anxiety.
And I spoke about social anxiety, and I stuttered the whole piece. People thought I was acting. People were like, oh man, the stutters, they sounded so real. I'm like, they are. They are. These are real stutters.
That's insane.
I got off the stage and I found people were like, I get you. I understand. I relate.
Yes.
And then I started, oh, dopamine. طب يلا بقى. أنا قاعد لكم. I'm not going anywhere. And then I started studying the poets. And then I started listening to rap differently.
Ya Allah.
بعدين بقى cadences وflows ومetaphors. خلاص دخلنا في السكة.
All from that one event
you
attended.
From that one event, yes sir.
What was it about poetry that attracted you? You said something interesting. You said that as if they're talking about things that they made things fun or they talked about.
They made the mundane observable. You know what I mean?
He's a poet.
They made the everyday to day things very important. And it's almost like meditating. It's like, oh, I'm on a table, there's a chair, it's gray, there's light. To put it in a poem. Mm-hmm. Let's sit, and then something happens to people when they hear you tell them what they already know.
You were so engaged with them at that point.
I was acknowledged. I was present completely. كل الانزايتي وكل الخوف وكل التوتر and all that like hesitation to exist went away.
Wow, what a beginning of the show. when you discovered yourself like that, sparked it, did you speak to the family about this passion of yours?
I think they found out. My parents always knew that I was a writer, but they didn't understand how much I loved it. Because at that point, obviously, like any parents or family, they just want you to be secure. They
Correct.
Want you to be safe.
Yeah.
But when they, 2 years later, they came to an event in Oman.
Ya Allah.
My parents, I remember very well, they didn't believe that there was close to 100 people in this room
Community.
Waiting for something. And I was that person providing that something. They were like, no, this kid has something to say.
Ya Allah.
And it's not just that, because Bless I started him. Writing about myself and my country and my family and everything that I come from. So they also yes. saw themselves in what I say.
Oh my God.
It wasn't just me at that point. Yeah, my parents were watching themselves. Am I Muslim?
Yeah, I love that.
Yeah, for sure.
Oh my God. Oh my God, that impacted me.
Yeah.
How do you say you've evolved from back in 2015 till now? Sure. What would you say Ziad Gadou evolution is?
شوف Ziad Gadou used to be a sporadic performer, a sporadic Hello? Writer.
Sporadic meaning spontaneous.
يعني اللي هو النهاردة أنا أكتب.
Great.
دلوقتي لا.
Really.
دلوقتي في I want to say curation,
really?
Which is something that you do very well.
Wow.
You curate an idea.
Mm.
Now there's music. Because the last 2-3 years I've been focused on honing the craft of production. Now I can start thinking, oh, that line, let's repeat that here and make that into a pre-chorus. مثلا فالموضوع دلوقتي بقى فيه how to use these tools to enhance an experience.
What?
مثلا very simple example, the tool of repetition. Repeating certain lines at specific moments in a piece
yes, yes.
creates like a snare feeling.
Big time.
If you talk about drums, if
yes,
you talk about hip hop,
I like that.
You know that snare, like when it ta ta, yeah. right? It's the same thing. You repeat a line, it hits.
You never got scared of adding music to this poetry?
I was terrified.
Wow.
No. I was terrified, and that's exactly why I did it. لأنه that fear is what made it like exciting. لأنه الأدرينالين مش هيجي من القعدة. فاهم قصدي? أنا I'm an adrenaline-driven person.
Yeah,
if this is scary, jump. Jump as fast as you can.
If this is scary, jump.
Jump. مفيش يعني when it comes to the truth of who I am, there's no debating it.
But you've always been like that, or this is...
I think so. I think it's also become more important as the poetry career took off, as people started acknowledging who I was in the community, and then also as I started bridging outside the community, as the singers started liking my work,
yes.
as the musicians started liking
yeah.
my work, as the non-artists started liking my work.
Me.
You know, like,
yeah.
that's not true. You have the art of letting
you,
people feel great about themselves. That's an art, man.
But Ziad, Ziad, remember the first time we connected?
I remember it was 2017. It was 7 years ago.
Wow.
Yeah.
Man, I walked in and you were like, "What? Who?" Like, I remember I was with Shibani, I remember. You know, God bless her. She's out in Canada right now. God bless her. But man, I was like,
Shout
who is
Shibani.
That? I'm like, I connected with this brother with the way you were talking and how you were talking.
There were a couple of lines about Iraq. And yes. That's when you walked in. Yes. You were like, ooh, ooh. And then Shibani was like, ooh, ooh, that guy.
Yeah. Oh, my
and
God.
And then, yeah, 7 years. And I knew of you. Yeah. And I'm like, yo, big fan. You're like, yo, bro, big fan. And then
it's amazing. It was instant. I think the reason why I say that is because, subhanAllah, you know, life goes on. And I've been here for like 6 years and a half. And I met you, obviously. And it's been just beautiful to get to see you evolve. And what's even more, I don't know if I told you this before, people realizing how much talent you are.
Yeah,
for me, this is like I'm so proud.
It's good. And
you
asked me.
You stuck through.
Yeah, and you asked me this question now, and I'm going to answer again. You asked me, like, what changed?
Yeah.
It started as for people. Now it's for me. That's what's changed.
Wait, I'm going to put the music down. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I think that's what's changed.
Because I need to be inspired of what you said. Because I, for the longest period of time, I've always never thought that way. Like, never thought it's for me. It's always for the people.
Man.
What was it that shifted that? Was it an organic shift?
I think it's to be honest, it's the people around me. Yani, when
shout
my
out
company,
to the people around you,
man, when the company changed, when I watched my closest friends reach goals that I know, like 5 years ago, you were writing that song that you're performing today at this event. I've watched you own who you are for 5 years, fight. And be stubborn about it, you know? I never thought about it that way until I realized the person who needed these poems the most was me. Me. Every time. Hatta right now, when I need a pickup, I watch one of my performances and I sit and I just process whatever I'm going through.
This is incredible, ladies and gentlemen. And that's only the first segment. The first 10 minutes, this brother is incredible. Ziad Gadou, definitely go follow him on social media. Right now, what I want to do is put you on the spot.
Yes.
I want to hear, obviously, we have four segments. Mm. Each segment, we want to end with a poem so people understand.
Yes.
About a couple of weeks ago, I had Salim Al-Attas as well here.
Yeah.
It was an amazing...
Shout out to Salim, man.
Shout out to him.
One of the people that, like, inspired me to start, even.
Wow.
Jesus Zain. I will always say that these two guys taught me how to walk the walk on stage.
Man, respect. Always. Respect always. To that. You're
absolutely.
Mentioning names here that I really...
Absolutely, bro. Absolutely.
So for me, I asked him about spoken word and what does it mean. What's your definition of it as spoken word?
Spoken word is... I think it's an accessible way to tell people things they didn't know they needed.
Mm.
That's what I think.
I love that.
That's the shortest definition I can
I like that definition. Yeah, it's cool.
People don't know that they need to hear these things.
Mm. And the way it's been told as well. The way
you say. It's not rap. Yes. You're not forced to focus on the time of the beat. I can stop. I can pause. I can repeat myself.
Yeah.
Yani, I can.
And it's also not your traditional kind of poetry.
Bizzabt. Exactly. Yeah. It's not that... You know, the classroom type of poetry, which is still beautiful in its own way.
Of course.
But it's not as engaging to me. To someone with like such a short attention span, زي NF حالتي, يعني, I need someone to bring me into the world, man. You know?
I love that. Okay, so listen, you're on the spot right now. I wanna kind of give you this platform to do something for us.
Yes.
Does it have a name? What are you going to do for us
I'm going to do a piece that I released in September of last year.
Okay.
I performed it at Blank Space. So big shout out to Blank Space.
Big.
One of the founding platforms for me.
Yeah.
This piece is called What Doesn't Kill You.
What Doesn't Kill You?
What Doesn't Kill You.
And when did you write this? You remember?
I wrote this in September itself.
September, okay.
Yeah, like a few days before the event. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Incredible.
Yeah.
Okay, I can't wait. I'm ready. Ladies and gentlemen, Ziad Gadou right here. Usually you have a musician, obviously, rapping or singing or playing. This guy right here is going to take you on a journey, and I can't wait. I haven't heard this, so I'm with you.
I'm excited for you, man.
I'm excited to hear it. What Doesn't Kill You?
What Doesn't Kill You?
By Ziad Gadou. Take it away.
What Doesn't Kill You? Dissociates you. PTSD abbreviates you. Sinks you, sends you to a menu of shrinks. Drinks you dry, depreciates you, jinx. A once upon a time sphinx who now knows less. Shrunk into a piece of your garden, you rose less. Hyperventilate, asphyxiate you, no less. Thick skin once, but now look at you, boneless.
Oh.
What doesn't kill you pauses your long-term memory. Mm. You're stuck in a moment where it could have all gone differently. Mm. Wishing you'd reacted, said something, punched back. Wishing you did more than just sit, stare, and react. Because everyone understands what you've been through. But no one understands what you've been through.
Mm-hmm.
So you sit on the wounds and ignore the scars. The smallest look or sound can scare away the hounds. Maybe a noise on the ground, even if no one's around. Maybe a child playing a ball, a little noise, a little fall. Trauma is not the occasional story to share. It's you being here, but your body being there. Mm. What doesn't kill you? throws you into an ocean, leaves you broken, lets you drown in emotion, so you numb away with silence or fake laughter, fake interest, or better yet, fake banter. One moment you're good, the next you're frozen, seeing what happened to you in everything unspoken. You drift away and float, isolate on a boat. Trauma is the gun that never needs to reload, so you slowly build walls, you seal shut, you feel none, tell yourself you fear none. You start to say things that you do not believe. You cut the strings with everything you love. Oof. So you have nothing to grieve. You see, in what doesn't kill you, you are misconceived, misunderstood, and misconstrued. You see, mistakes are made so we can dig for the truth, so we can learn to lose pain to the ego with bruise. What doesn't kill you will let you know that you need to let the hurt sink. You need to let it show. Hold on to pain, and it will fight you back. The best defense against will always be to attack. So when the time comes to say, I have nothing left to say, and the earthquake in your chest divides you like night and day, and the voice of your demon hits a mute note, pat yourself on the shoulders because you just used growth. It's okay to mourn the pain for as long as you need.
Wow.
It's okay to learn to pray and get down on your knees, learn mercy again like you've never seen it once. Learn to forgive the aggressor, learn to put down the guns, erase all the names on the blacklist of your enemies, and write a diary entry that starts with, "Dear better me, I love you for every moment they didn't, so just let it be." But this is not the end. Life happens to teach, so take the lesson as friend. Tell yourself, "I will not leave you. I will not leave you." Tell yourself, "I will not leave you. I will not leave you." Tell yourself, "I will not leave you. I will not leave you." So forget the ads, the trends, and the blinds. Forget the checks and the signs. Forget the red flags. Forget the crimes. You have paid your dues. You have done your time. This soul, body, hand, foot, spine. These eyes heavy with love, ready to build and grind, ready to build something worth your name and time. You are made with love, intricately designed. Who are you to redefine something made in the image of the divine? Remember, what doesn't kill you branches your needs flowing. It is the wind blowing. It is the trees knowing that some leaves have to fall to make room for the seeds growing.
Wow. I never gave anybody two round of applause. And what? Does it make sense that I'm emotional about this?
Yes.
Because obviously I'm 43 years old. I've been doing what I'm doing since 2006 and 7. And I don't know, there's so many ways I connected with this record. It was like an octopus to me. It was like, you first, boom, line one, connect one. Doom, line two, line three. And it was like, all of a sudden, I'm surrounded by Ziad Gadou words. And
all eight of us are hitting you at the same time.
Yeah, you saw that. The first couple of minutes, I'm like getting hooked. And the last minute, I was like, done. Khalas. Man, bless you. Thank you for being who you are. I'm going to say this method, which I always say. الإنسان الذي لا أثر له لا حياة له. A human being with no impact has no life. And
beautiful.
Man, you're able to impact so many people. Anyone that heard this, you've impacted them in a way, because we all go through that. Wow. Another one of applause, ladies and gentlemen. There's a lot of things to talk about still, but I have a segment on the show where I ask the guest what song to play. Obviously, we're on the FM radio. We have to play a song right now. It was Break. Do you have anything in mind, Ziad?
Mosalem, Meganin.
Meganin!
Goes without saying.
Shout out to Mosalem.
Let's go.
Big love and respect to him, of course.
Of course, bro. My brother.
We're going to be right back. Mosalem right now on 95 FM. Keep it locked. I have with me the incredible, obviously, spoken word poet, guitarist, producer, human being, Ziad Gadou. Do not go anywhere.
Catch a vibe with Big Hass. Only on Pulse. Pulse 95.
Only on Pulse 95 Radio, ladies and gentlemen. Big Hass with you guys right here on Catch a Vibe. The beats that you hear in the background is by a producer called Bugsy. Shout out to him. He's an incredible guy. Yeah, which means fire. I got my guest with me, obviously, for today's episode. I hope you're having a blessed Saturday. I mean, seriously, what a way to begin. He's an incredible, obviously, poet, human being, writer, guitarist, producer. But when you impact people that way, it's just really massive. And we got to know a little bit about why he got into the poetry space. Ziad, I want to ask you, what has been the main challenge in your life as a challenge? What was it about poetry and life that challenged you, and how did you pass through it?
I think that poetry does not leave details out. يعني انت تخيل نفسك, imagine yourself, you're going into a place and you're meeting you know, someone for the first time and you're telling them a story of who you are, you want them to know all the parts. You wish they were there. That's how I write. I write as if I want you to be fully in my head.
I love that.
Faham Azli? That's why, for example, I'm going to go back to Kendrick Lamar. Because Kendrick writes and leaves nothing to your imagination.
Yeah.
Most of the time. Yeah. I want to say most of the time. He knows how to balance that act of like, let me entertain you, but let me sit you down and introduce you to that specific moment in my life.
And you know what's interesting that you say that? For me, the artist was Nas. Like when I first heard Illmatic and all that. So for me, I connected with that. He took me to New York. He made me live in New York. I've never been to New York. And he took me to the streets.
You can imagine it. You can see it in your head. Exactly, right? So do that without music. I have to paint you a very clear image and picture.
That was a challenge early on for you.
Of course, of course, of course. But also it came easy to me because I'm a talkative person.
But it's interesting because you knew that from the beginning. That you went,
man. And I will like, this platform happened out of thin air for me. It's like, oh, it's been like this forever. People can talk in length about their emotions and their experiences. And there's other people who compete with each other. That's the stick. What glued this is the competition part.
Yeah.
I was like, no, I'm better than you.
Yeah.
I want to do it better than you.
But that's crazy.
I started like competing with everyone I saw. And I started like sharpening the pen.
Yeah.
And then I started also borrowing at like Jace. I'm gonna go back to Jace's saying. Jace has a walk.
Yeah.
When he gets on stage.
Facts.
I
know what you're talking about.
You know what I mean? He sits and then.
Yeah.
And then he. Shamelessly, I've borrowed that from him.
Oh man.
Shamelessly, I say that.
Love,
right?
Love.
So there's a lot of these little tricks and, you know, we all borrow from each other because it's such a tight knit community.
Correct.
And Hakam was here just recently and he said the same thing.
Mm.
It's a community that uplifts.
So good.
لأنه ما فيش مصالح. There's no like this like,
oh, no this ego, poem,
your royalty from this. There's no this like financial sort of obligation because it's a space to express.
Correct.
So we all borrow from each other these tools of self-defense. We're all protecting ourselves from demons, you know.
Incredible.
But let me just take that walk. Let me just take that, you know. Thank you so much for that.
And I think when you mention people like Jason Zane, I think when they hear that from you, it kind of really gives them even more hope. I think it inspires them to continue.
He knows this. I tell him this on every time he calls me, every time I call him, I make sure to remind him, like, thank you for inspiring me every time.
That's massive. Sure. Okay, that's interesting, like how you talked about challenges. But and this is a question that's very difficult to ask, especially with anyone who is independent. How do you sustain yourself in everything that you're doing in terms of, like, you know, just art generally?
Right. So, alhamdulillah, 100 times, I've been blessed to be in positions where I can get paid to do what I do. So, alhamdulillah, I've been lucky enough to do that on a non-stage level where I'm writing things and being commissioned to do pieces.
That's amazing.
To be displayed in different locations or as a songwriter.
How does that feel when your work gets displayed?
Like, unreal. When someone calls me and tells me, oh, I saw this thing at that gallery or at that exhibition or at that, you know, display and I saw your name and I was really excited. I'm like, that's an extension of myself you're looking at, you know? That's humbling.
And obviously, for people who are listening, you get paid for the, like, you get paid for these commissions.
You can get commissioned. Yes, absolutely. There's so many ways that your poetry can find places. هي الفكرة كلها إنه you have to be everywhere, like because you have to double down on yourself.
Was that difficult transition? Like,
of course, of course. There was a year and a half where I didn't perform and I didn't go on stage at all because I was dealing with a bunch of things.
Mm.
And in that year, I was not a poet. I was just a 9-to-5.
Wow.
Whatever 9-to-5 I was doing at the time, that was all I was doing. But بعدين, when I got on stage again, and I'm like, you know what? I'm letting go. Forget all of the convictions I have of what it's supposed to be. Let it go. Let it come to you. وسبحان ربك. ربك رزق.
Wow.
God just knows where you are and knows how to find you.
Yeah. Wow. Man. I don't know what to say with this, brother.
Yeah. Poetry and music are not just commodity.
Can I ask you a personal question?
Of course.
Well, how old are you?
I'm turning 30 in July.
You're 30?
I'm turning 30.
Oh my, I want to say turning 30.
But I like to say that because I'm excited for the 30s. Yeah. To be very honest, I want to say almost 30.
The head on your shoulder, like, it's just crazy in terms of this brother has been doing poetry since 2015,
yes,
right?
Yes.
So it's been just crazy to see him evolve like that and the way he thinks. And by the way, I'm leaving out many things in terms of, like, all the private conversation me and Ziad have. I want to say thank you in front of everybody because this brother always checks in on me. Always.
I appreciate you.
At the times where I'm not feeling well, he just says, hello, I just want to make sure you're okay. and that for me.
And you did the same in 2021, and I'm never gonna forget it. I posted a video at the time and I wasn't feeling well, and I explained it in length. Mm. And you called me immediately, you're like, come, let's talk about it.
Yeah.
That lack of hesitation for me shot you up 100 points. Mm. 100 points to Gryffindor.
If someone
take your flowers as you are, bro. Take the flowers.
What would you say you write about? Like, mainly, what are the things that inspire you to kind of talk about? I know it's from within you, but if you want to kind of not box it in, but like topics wise.
I want to say, yani, mental health.
Okay.
Primarily mental health.
Which is important, yani, for an Arab, you know, man to talk about
bizzabt,
that.
Bizzabt. And it started finding home in these ideas. You're a man, you're an Arab, you're a son, you're the eldest son, you're a partner, wa ila akhru. For these all these labels, there's so much to talk about. There's so many micro interactions, so many moments that deserve highlighting. And what do I write about? The pattern in these moments. في لحظة, أنت مثلاً كابن, you're a son.
Yeah.
And then you're like, oh, the way my mother walks into the kitchen in the morning when she sees me sitting outside in the living room. There's a son, there's a counter, there's a tea being made, there's Umm Kulthum playing in the background somewhere, my father's rambling about something on the corner, my brother just...
You're painting a picture.
Frame, shot,
incredible.
That's it.
Man, okay. Listen, I want to put you on the spot again.
Please.
We'd love to hear from you.
And I'm Akhlas Subh.
Obviously, is this one you're going to do in Arabic?
So, yeah, actually, I want to thank someone.
Okay.
I want to thank Dunya Wael.
Dunya Wael?
Dunya Wael.
What?
Dunya Wael? Yes. I want to thank Dunya Wael.
Shout out Dunya Wael.
Dunya Wael has been borderline bullying me to perform in Arabic. And I promised her.
Shout out to her, of course.
This year is the year I'm going to perform spoken word in Arabic on stage.
Because, man, she's right. Because you have the way you're taught, like you said it, we connect with it. And even the terminology is in Arabic.
Yes.
He's so good at it. Oh man, I can't wait.
Dunya Wael specifically, she's an incredible writer, an incredible artist, but more so, she's a very encouraging artist to artists.
God bless her.
She retains these relationships very well.
God bless her.
And she continues to like, send me poems. Why haven't you sent
me a poem?
Obviously,
listen, I would say this. Shout out to her. I would say this on her behalf. I know that you impacted her, and that's why she's feeling that
way. Yes, absolutely.
So I think when we get impacted by people like that, we encourage them to drop more, release more, do this more, and it just comes like
borderline bullying.
God bless you. Does this have a title?
مخصمني,
which means
you're not talking to
we're
me.
We're not talking.
Like, sort of like you're not talking. Okay. We don't talk anymore.
We don't talk anymore. I love that. We don't talk anymore.
Selina Abdul Basit.
Selina Abdul Basit. Yeah, Allah. All right, you guys, you're about to hear, obviously, Ziad Gadou's, you know, poetry. It is in Arabic, so if you understand, cool. If not, hopefully, maybe one day you get to learn this beautiful language. Ziad Gadou, take it away.
مخصمني؟ ماشي. حقك علي. ما أقدرش ألومك. ما أقدر ظروفك. عارف إنك مكتوم أو يمكن أنا اللي كتمتك. ما عادتش بترد علي ولو بالألم كتبتك. عارف اني مش احسن واحد ياخد باله ولا يهتم علموني السكوت وفن الردم كنت احسن واحد يرقص مع الغم بعد ما اتعلمت الرجوله وسقت وصلت اخر نفق الهم اتعلمت اتجاهل وهو زعل مني طفلي اللي جوايا مغلبني معتمني ما بيكلمنيش زعلان مني اني ما ببكيش ما بشتكيش اني بفتري وما بشتريش سالني امتى اخر مره ابتسمت في وش واحد غريب وليه وزن الضحكة تقل ولو معكش تمنها ليه ما قلتليش ده حتى سعر الحب نزل قلت له ما تدوشنيش انا مش قافل عليك من مفيش عيط وزعق براحتك بس الدنيا صعبة مش عايز حنية عايز اللي يسكت ويسلم عايز اللي ما يشتكيش حاولت اخد كل اللي ليا واسيب اللي مليش عاتبتني ووبختني وانا قدامك اهو ما بيديش اطلعك من جوه ليه وسكنك فين وأكلك منين يلزمك حب واهتمام ووقت واتزان أرقام تليفونات نحفظها وصور ناس نعرفها يلزمك تتحضن وتتباس بس أنا ما حلتيش غير طبية وترباس أجيب لك منين ده الحب اللي انت اتعلمته في الأساس طفل صوته عالي دوشة والكبار ما يحبوش الروشة يحبوا الشيشة والكورة والشكوى والندم وياسطة ومسلسل الأسطورة بيقولوا لك اهمد لو نطيت أو اسكت لو قلت نكتة لنفسك وضحكت يقولوا لك اعقل لو حلمت ولو غلبك اليأس يسموها كسلت، يقولوا لك راجع نفسك فتحسك انت تكنسلت. ادي الناس اللي يلزموك، اللي يقولوا لك ما تمثلش، بيعشقوا الافلام. احبك ازاي وانا مخبي خوفي ورا وحاطط شتيمه قدام؟ يمكن لما اوسخ لساني يعملوا لي قيمه، ولما ارجع البيت اقول اتوضى واغسل ذنوبي، فجيب لي نص ليفه استحمى تغسل دموعك فيها. جعان كل دمعه عينيك على رسم ضحكتين حلو وحادق، اشبع بقى وفض نصيره. كل وتهنى واطلب تلاقي سفره الدنيا مسرح ملاهي، ثانيه سحبه وراها ساعه بتنادي، والعمر واقف مستغرب يندهني ابعد كل ما يقرب. بتلومني وانا ماشي بجهاز استشعار، بتحسسني ان اصغر نظره غلط وراها حرب ودمار، وان كل اللي بيحبني تعلب مكار، واني مهما عملت خير في دنيتي مسيره دفن في اخر النار. ما عندكش مهل ولا صبر ولا انتظار، خوفك وشكك صحبتك ورفقتك ملازمينك من سنين، في طوابيرك وزحمتك واقفين ومراقبين، عارفين طباعك ورقتك عجنين وخبزين، يحموا ظهرك ووشك وحبك ولهفتك من سين ومن جيم، وعد يومك وافرد سحنتك، ما احنا كده لابسين لابسين. خوفك وشكك صحابك في محنتك يختفوا لما تنهار، فتلومني على وكستك وما تلتمسليش اعذار. ولما فوق من فزعتي القى قلبي في النسيان، يا استاذ الطرب، يا مهندس نغمه الخزيان، يا عصفور المحبه، يا عندليب السلكان، يا ادب فضلوك عن العلم، يا ملك وسط غلمان. مش عايز تنام؟ هجيب لك تاكل قريب، بس ما تحسسنيش ان انت اللي شرير وانا اللي طيب. طيب مش هتسامحني؟ ماشي، حقك. مش هعرف اغير رايك بكره، ولا هتفضل قافل البيبان عليا، يمكن الصبح يغيرك او الشمس تصفي حساباتنا وتعوضنا الخسائر من غير انتقام. على العموم سلام، انا هخش انام، خلي يومنا يعدي بسلام، يمكن بكره الاقي مودك يسمح بالكلام.
What? Yo, ladies and gentlemen, I haven't heard these poems. Oh my god, man. Another round of applause. He's getting choked. What? Ziad, this is incredible.
أول مرة أعمل عربي. This is my first Arabic performance ever.
Like, this is crazy.
Ever.
As I know that you've dealt with Arabic and English before. Mm, like,
yes.
You know, you kind of
yes,
dabbled
mixed,
with it.
Yes.
But this is kind of the first time.
Yes. Yes.
How does that make you feel?
Accomplished. To be honest,
that was so
Arabic
cool.
Language. You know this very well.
Yeah, yeah.
The Arabic language is a royal.
Oh my
language.
God! Yeah, it is. It is.
I tread very carefully.
Man.
يعني I have the utmost.
Yeah.
Like respect for this language.
It
I cannot
shows.
Walk in. يعني دمي يعني sort of undermining أيوة. Anything. I
yeah.
have to be fully present
yeah.
and fully aware.
Oh man.
Of the kind of quality I'm bringing
that,
to the table.
That for me, this what you said, like yeah, man, that's incredible. For me, I think. Yeah, you're onto something right here.
Yeah, Musa.
Wallah.
توكلنا على الله.
Man, oh man. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to be taking a short break. And here I ask my guest again, what song can I play? Mm. And again, it could be a song from you, you know, any record. You know, I know that you're producing and you're doing
yes,
your
sir.
Own thing.
Yes,
so
sir.
Whatever you feel like, we can play and for people to hear.
I think we can transition into a calmer state of mind.
Show me.
I'd like to play, if you don't mind, I'd
yeah.
like to request my song.
Okay.
Gadou.
Of course.
The Quiet of Rain.
Okay.
It's a lo-fi song. It's
yeah.
chill.
Love
Let's just all lay back and
Let's
relax.
Do that. And listen, I'm going to say this right now. I'm going to include this record to be part of the rotation on the station. So meaning it will play at 3:30 a.m. at 2 p.m. It doesn't
حلوة
have to play
at 3:30 a.m. حلوة
yes.
دي أنا
yeah.
بكون صاحي
yeah exactly it don't matter what time but yeah let's play this record ladies and gentlemen Ziad Gadou on Catch a Vibe right here on Pulse 95 Radio we will be right back do not go anywhere
Catch a Vibe with Big Hass only on Pulse Pulse 95.
Only on Pulse 95 Radio, ladies and gentlemen. Catch a Vibe with my guest, who is an incredible spoken word poet, a human being, a producer, a guitarist, someone who is just really an incredible, like I said, amazing guy. We just actually heard his record, The Quiet of Rain, and we were talking off air. You know, I was asking him what's the record about. And one thing I really appreciate about our artist is this, is that he is always, always down to talk about it. And what I feel... And if you don't mind me saying this, Ziad.
No, I don't.
I'm saying that, I'm saying for me, I think I know you well enough for me to ask you these uncomfortable, you know, questions.
We've had so many personal conversations.
Exactly.
That were,
and that for me, I yeah. think it's a great connection.
Yes,
so ma'am. when we talk about The Quiet of Rain, tell me a little bit about it. I know it has an emotional, obviously, story to you. Tell me
yeah.
a little bit about it.
طيب.
Whatever خالي, you can, of course.
خالي ناجي الدسوقي. الله يرحمه.
Naged.
My uncle
Naged.
Nagi, was like a big brother to me. When my parents were being strict, he was the fun uncle. You know those, you know that fun uncle comes in, sneaks in like sweets, take like some money, goes. He's that kind of person.
God bless.
And we became very, very close when I went back to Cairo to finish my military service. We bonded. We bonded as I bonded with him as a child, and I bonded with him as an adult. So his passing was very difficult for me to deal with, and this song came out of it.
Because
So basically, the metaphor is the music video. You see it in the music video.
Yes.
There's traffic.
Yeah.
Traffic is the thoughts. It's a traffic of thoughts. Of sadness, maybe, of anger, whatever the feelings you feel when you're mourning loss.
Yeah.
And rain comes as relief. The song drops as rain on the car in the music video. The car flies out of the traffic for 3 minutes and then it lands back again.
Ya Allah.
For 3 minutes, I'm okay. Soothed by the rain.
Wow.
I think that's my read a year later. But at the time, I wasn't thinking about it like that.
Yeah.
For while I was doing it, I didn't have all this in my mind. I was just processing.
Yeah.
For the song came to heal me.
God rest his soul.
I mean, Allah yarhamu yani.
Allah yarhamu.
Beautiful person. This is a tribute to him.
Man. God rest his soul in peace. Thank you so much for sharing that.
Of course, Thank you. Thank you for being kind and asking that.
No, I mean, you know, we want to create this safe space here. And I think with people like you, I think we all go through that. And I think it's really incredible. Wow. Incredible video as well.
Yeah.
Who did
Shout out to Jonah Atallah. He's a Swiss Egyptian animator, director.
Incredible.
He's a phenomenal artist.
I love
we
it.
Linked online through Noura Zaid.
Oh, shout out to Noura Zaid. OG right now.
Yeah. So through her, we got in touch. And then when I was working on the song, immediately I was like, I'd like to do a video with you.
Wow.
Thank him, Yanni,
for that. But go check it out, you guys. It's The Quiet of Rain, of course. It's on streaming, obviously, platforms. And it's on Ziad Gadou's, obviously, YouTube channel as well. Ziad, speaking of that and music, how... as a producer, how did you start dabbling
into this? I've been waiting for this question.
I know you guys, every now and then he would send me something on WhatsApp, like, check this out. And I love his passion. Like, seriously, I love his passion. And I love the fact that, you know, sometimes maybe I can't see it, or, you know, I don't reply right away and he's still there.
La, I'm here to borderline bully you into it.
No, let's go.
What Dunya Wael did with me, I'm about to do with you.
No, but how did the production thing start with you?
So, long story short, rap, hip hop, beats.
Okay.
And a Biggie Smalls, I used to sit and study how this dude flows on the snare.
Ya Allah.
Bienzil syllables kida on the snare, and you're like, how is it so smooth?
Yeah.
And then I started dabbling into production and I found sampling.
Okay.
The technique of sampling. And then I kind of started digging into Ninth Wonder, DJ Premier, Jay Dilla, Nujabes.
Yeah.
Then and then for my birthday, my friends and my brother, they all got me an MPD. It's like a small MPC.
Yeah.
And then I started chopping samples.
Really?
Very badly on Ableton.
No.
And shout out to Lekt Ammar, who got me my first Ableton. Shout out to Lekt, bro.
Lekt the rapper?
Lekt the rapper, yes sir.
What?
Yes sir.
I'm a big fan of this guy.
I went to his house, he gave me my first Ableton.
Yo, this guy has Mars.
He's incredible.
Yeah, yeah.
Producer Mur'ib.
He's underrated.
He got me into production.
No way.
Practically, he was ba'adni and he explained to me this is how. And then I realized, similar to poetry, it's a canvas. A kick, a hi-hat, a snare, bass line, a sample.
It's a canvas, but it's not for everybody. Like, I've been doing this since 2006. I never really got into it. So for you, what was it about that you got into
it? I think I wholeheartedly disagree with you.
Okay.
I think it is for everybody. You know, once you watch someone make something and you're like, oh, so that's how they make that. That's all it takes.
Yeah, but you're just making it easier. Right?
That's the point.
Yeah. Yeah.
It became accessible for me.
Okay.
And I have an obsessive tendency. When I like something, I obsess.
I love that.
And when I got the guitar, I used to play 10 hours a day for 2 years. I was obsessed. I was possessed with it.
Yeah.
Same way, I was obsessed with sampling. How does that song... And then I realized all pop music is sampled.
Fact.
All your favorite songs are sampled.
Everything is sampled. تعالي لي بقى من الأول.
What is the sampling thing?
أيوة.
بعدين I started digging into the very delicate sounds. This specific snare, this specific drum set. And then a big shift in the game for me was Wiley. Wiley is an Egyptian producer. Phenomenal.
Yeah.
My favorite producer right now.
Shout out to him.
Wiley has very intricate sound design. And that's a whole world of its own. يعني. I don't want to get into it.
Yeah, yeah.
ولكن مش بس sampling, لا, اختيار الصوت.
Facts.
You can create sounds. You don't have to sample. I'm a guitarist.
Yeah.
I can put guitars down, play with the sound design, and create something entirely unique.
Yeah, 100%.
You know what I mean? So that's... I'm going to geek out and nerd about it, but the point is... Aywa, salam. La 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 la. Al-Wayli. موضوع كبير.
Shout out to Al-Wayli.
موضوع كبير جدا.
I think... I try to say something. The producers specifically in Egypt played a big role in putting, you know, hip-hop...
On the, yes, absolutely.
On this map. Absolutely. Because even that big producers like Timbaland have sampled Arabic music before.
Yes,
right
yes,
now, there
yes.
is something called an Egyptian type beat.
Yes, sir.
You know what that means?
Yes, sir.
That means that they made
it. Yes, sir.
You know?
Yes, sir.
A Kendrick type beat. Rap Sha'bi.
Trap Sha'bi.
Yeah.
Al-Wayli
inspired you like that.
Al-Wayli inspired me جدا. Right now in music, now I'm starting to fuse my spoken word with my production.
Ya Allah.
وصلت المرحلة إنه and alhamdulillah it happened in 2018 with Iman Zajali and Ghazi Belushi and Cruise Control.
Beautiful record.
From there,
that by the way gets still aired till now.
I love that song so much and it's a staple and it's a standard for me. And I was lucky enough to work on it with so many people. From there, I started focusing on how can I refine my sound as a poet to create music that is two or three or whatever the song needs. But برضو I'm the producer, so I control your experience completely, and that gives me a lot of like ability to manipulate the experience.
Wow!
This is the soft spot for me right now. Right now I'm creating music.
You're in there.
And this year there's two songs coming.
Wow!
And I'm very very excited to share them.
Technically speaking, the song obviously you dropped. Is this the only record you dropped officially?
The Quiet of Rain was a lo-fi sort of like moment.
Yeah.
It was an instrumental moment. Yeah. I'm not on it.
Okay.
These two songs, these are songwriting songs.
Any dates?
لا.
Like, okay, no dates.
يعني بنتأمل من الله إنه الأمور تستقر في العموم.
Of course. I mean, what's going on in Palestine and Sudan?
Exactly, exactly. For regionally, when things are a little bit more calmer and stagnant, I can start thinking about when to release because I have to honor.
So they are ready. You know? The records are ready.
Yes. Okay. Shout out to MCM because we just recorded both songs in Cairo. Yes,
what?
Sir.
MCM?
Yes, sir.
Incredible guy.
Yes, sir. Phenomenal.
What?
Phenomenal engineer.
Yo, man.
Phenomenal engineer. See, phenomenal artist.
When Egyptians start getting to kind of connect with one another.
E'la.
Yeah, E'la. That's the word.
When Egyptians bond, E'la.
Yeah, we need to do a record called E'la. I love that.
Let's do it. Let's
seriously.
Do it, bro.
E'la. E'la. Get Afrut.
I'm telling you, E'la. We just wrapped up the songs and we're releasing them this year, inshallah.
Can we talk about the names or no?
Like what are they called? Yes, I don't mind sharing them. Clarity is the first song, and Kaleidoscope.
And they're both in English?
And they're both in English.
Okay, and you produced this, right?
Produced everything, yes.
Oof, I can't wait.
Yeah.
I can't wait.
Me too.
What did MCM think, at least?
MCM lost it. He loved it. Oh. He's like, you're doing something no one's doing. You're
really?
A spoken word poet who produces.
Yes, yeah.
That's insane.
So you're not rapping, you're doing poetry?
That's up to you to decide.
Okay.
Where you want to put it is up to you to decide. Like, this is me fully خلاص بقى, letting go.
Speaking of letting go, and I really appreciate you. It's been a crazy discussion. We're towards the end, but it's mental. I kind of want to talk to you about something I know that you're very vocal about, which is obviously poetry and discussing social issues. And I think it's truly important. Like, we all have to speak up. I know the only Nina Simone spoke about it. An artist's duty is to reflect the time he or she is in.
Yeah.
This is the duty, and this is Nina Simone speaking. And I really truly believe in that. You can't be tone deaf if you're an artist because you're human first. And you're like not discussing this in your art somehow, some way. You can do it straight to the point. Mm-hmm. You can do it visually.
Yeah.
But you have to address it. Now, with you in this context, how does that work with everything that's going on in our life right now? Because it impacts us all, Ziad. When you see visuals of people being displaced and all these things, it impacts you as a human, you know?
I don't think anyone's doing okay.
Facts.
To be very honest with
facts.
You. I don't think any of us is doing okay. Yani, we come here and we talk about our goals and our dreams and our ambitions, but ultimately we are trying to begin to process the size of the disaster, you know? Just begin to understand, you know?
Yeah.
Yani, I was lucky to be invited to a couple of platforms, to be around a lot of friends who are dealing with a lot.
Mm.
And I was also lucky to perform.
Yeah, yeah.
And I have a piece called A Moment of Silence.
Oh, man.
And it's heavy.
Mm.
And it makes me cry, makes other people cry.
Mm.
Fa,
Can we perform that? Is that the one you perform?
I might, yes. Okay. I think I might do that.
Okay. Or whatever you had in mind. But
No. I think that's appropriate. Okay. I think that's an appropriate piece to perform. Right now, you know, with the things happening in Sudan and in Palestine, yeah. I think there is nothing more on anyone's mind.
Fact.
It's our job and it's our duty to support. بكل الأشكال وبكل المعاني.
I fully agree. I fully agree and I respect, you know, I think...
And poetry has a revolutionary role to play in this.
100%.
I'm not undermining that.
No.
And I'm saying it again, a revolutionary role in the... في الشعوب. في مصائر الشعوب.
Correct.
Poetry is the heart and soul
worldwide,
of movement.
Worldwide, not only in this region, obviously.
أيوة, لأن لما when you're out of options... ما فيش غير لسانك
yeah.
انتهى الموضوع يا باشا
Facts.
انتهى الموضوع yeah. كان زمان القبائل بتتعارك بالشعرة
correct.
النهاردة الشعوب بتدافع عن نفسها بالشعر
yeah,
بالكلمة
yeah, I mean people
يعني
are defending their shorn
our feeling of helpless our feeling of helplessness you know mm. that feeling we are doing our best no. and I will continue to do our best always
but listen the fact that you feel that way it means something because a lot of people are not feeling that
course.
Way you know we are at the end of the day we're one ummah right like it's one body And if part of your body get impacted, I think it's really amazing.
I think, يعني, and I'm going to answer that just because I need to say it. Address your privilege. Arguk, address your privilege before, like, if you're apathetic, I don't think anyone's apathetic. Mm. I think you just have a wall around you that's not letting you really realize that this is about you. As much as it's about you, it is about them.
Facts.
الموضوع مش بعيد على فكرة.
Yeah.
We're all in this together way more than we
way
think.
Way more than we think. I agree with that. When did you write this piece?
I wrote this
when the
October.
Situation started. Okay.
October.
Okay. If you want to dedicate it to anybody, please go ahead. We're about
يعني,
to hear it.
I'm going to dedicate it to the children of Gaza.
Okay.
Each and every single one. I'm going to dedicate it to the displaced population of Sudan.
Mm-hmm.
All the friends and family that have arrived in Cairo. نورونا يعني على رأسنا من فوق بس يعني it still hurt. Mm-hmm. Still hurts. Still, it's very, very painful. And this piece is called A Moment of Silence.
A moment of silence. Okay. Ziad Gadou, take it away.
A moment of silence for Palestine, for Sudan, for Lebanon, for Iraq, for the not numbers. For the faces, for the dreams and the places, for the schools, the hospitals, mosques and churches, mm-hmm. for the evidence stacked, negligent in searches, for a mother wailing in a silent degree, for a father carrying bags of remains and debris, mm-hmm. for a sister and a brother and a tree and a home, for the chaos back home breaking up the backbone, For the image that you painted that is not mine. We are not the sons of the grave you design. When a colonizer claims his, what was always mine. When a paper drawn border through my name in a folder, through my skin in a folder, through my blood in a folder, let it rot till revenge grew thick with shoulders, because we are not the sons of the grave you design. We are not a sum on a plane you devise. We are not a sinking boat of wrong answers. We are not the missing poems. We are the stanzas. Read through your history, you ignorant sheep. The land remembers what the guns will not keep. Tell your castles that mountains move, that planets quake, that every empire must fall, and we will be there to celebrate. We are not the sons of the grave you design. We do not come with blood stains intertwined. We are not the victims you frame in minds. We are not helpless. Nor dragging behind, we are not surrender, defeat, or the end. Now you call me enemy when I try to be friend. Don't get it twisted and let's not pretend. Shields can be swords at just the right bend. And at just the right angles, pain turns to pen. With just the right scream, one voice turns to ten. When a child burns to ash, a mother turns to beast. Roaring for the pack to bring her back a full feast. We are not the sons of the graves that you made. And you still fall prey to the same old mistakes. You have the guns and the ships and the planes. We have a God and we have a faith. We do not die, we multiply. We eat acid rain for lunch, we digest. We mock you on the screen, you jokes, you digests. You hide behind your castles, we'll take you with no vest. We are not the sons of the graves that you missed. Death is not the end to a man who submits. Keep paying for the graves and the walls and the gates. Keep paying for blood for your generational hate. You act so afraid, your claims are limited. Your name is so fake, it has the word real in it. But let's reel it in. I feel sorry for you. Living with all that fear, just to cry when rebuked. No one swears it wasn't him more than a guilty thief. Your feet shaky, flaky is your so-called belief. So forget a moment of silence. This is a moment to scream for a free Syria, Iraq, Lebanon, Sudan, and a free Palestine.
Wow. Wow. Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to say that what we just heard right now from Ziad, I got to ask you this before we take a break. Is it hard to write stuff like that? Like
I was crying while writing. I can't hear this.
Because we hear it, we receive it, and it's heavy. And you want to definitely, you know, scream like towards the end. You just made me live this moment. You took me on a journey with you.
Yeah.
And I was like feeling that I wanted to hear that word. I wanted to hear the screaming.
Yeah.
When you said forget moment of silence, and you said, like, you know,
when I did this live, I screamed. I put the mic aside and I screamed very loudly to disturb people. I can't do that in
But it's hard to write, right?
This is me demanding my body to deal with it. Right now, we are thinking about all of this right now, and we're making sense of it. These events are chaotic.
Yeah.
They make your body question itself.
Correct.
So poetry bordo grounds you.
Grounds you.
What's the mission, the focus of this piece and any other piece, and all poets will tell you this.
Yeah.
They're just trying to process something that they cannot hold in their hands.
Yeah. No, but in the span of that, you're also inspiring us to think and to connect. So man, God bless you, man.
Yeah.
Seriously, wow.
Yeah.
What a piece. Wow.
Ya Rabbi Awina Gamiya.
Yeah, I mean, what do you have in mind in terms of playing a song? Like, can we play? I think after something like that, do you have something in mind?
Do you wanna take it away?
I wanted to play something from the Palestinian folklore.
I think that's what you should do.
Yeah, like, you know, Ya Zari Fatul or something like that.
Please,
yeah. Let's do that.
Yalla bina.
Let's do that. Let's definitely play that. Big love and respect. But shout out to people who actually, you know, like, take matters into their own hand like that and discusses matters like this that are really important.
We are stronger than we think.
100%.
We are stronger than we think.
I love that you said that.
We are stronger than we think we are. And I want to shout out my friend Mahmoud Hassouna. Right now, who has been keeping me together. Wow. I don't know how to feel. He's like, we're great. We're strong. That's a Palestinian man.
He's a Palestinian.
That's Palestinian right there.
Wow. Shout out to Mahmoud Hassoun.
Shout out to all of them.
Man, blessed.
Strength beyond strength.
100%. We're going to be right back, you guys. It's impossible to end the conversation with this brother. Just, wow. We're going to be right back, you guys. This is Ya Zari Fatul, which is obviously from the Palestinian folklore. Let's hear a little bit of it. And we're going to be right back. Keep it locked. It's Pulse 95.
Catch a vibe with Big Hass. Only on Pulse. Pulse 95. Pulse. All our pretty pictures at Pulse 95 Radio on Instagram.
Pulse. Man, oh man, ladies and gentlemen, it's Pulse 95 Radio. Catch a vibe with me, Big Hass. Airs every Saturday and Sunday from 9 p.m. to 10 p.m. Today's episode is definitely a special one. We might get over a little bit over like past 10, but it's definitely worth it. I have with me Ziad Gadou, who is an incredible, you know, poet, artist, guitarist, producer, just really an amazing human being. We just heard a little bit of Ya Zari Fatul, and you know, he just did a beautiful, beautiful piece that I really connected with. Ziad, when we play this record, what's the first thing that comes to your mind?
Ya Salam. Knowledge, the producer. That's the first thing I think of.
Yeah.
How did he make the... Woo! It's bouncy and solid, and it has an identity.
Heaven. That's Kendrick Lamar's Mama.
One of my favorite records of all time. How this album came together is also something like incredible.
Like
organic music making is unbelievable.
100%.
Unbelievable.
I think it's definitely iconic for sure. Okay, Ziad, I got to talk about a couple of things. Obviously, for those of you who don't know, Ziad is also an author. You've done, what is it, Provoke?
Yes, sir. I've released a book in 2018 that I am very grateful that you had a copy of.
Oh, man.
When I wasn't even here.
I had a copy of. Shout out to Sale Publishing,
yes,
Iman.
Yes, absolutely.
You know, I was there. I was like, yeah, of course. And she gave me your book. And I was like, wow.
Yeah, it was incredible.
So, okay, I know that you're in the midst of writing another book.
Yes, I'm finishing up my second book.
Amazing. So I want to talk about that. But what would you say is, like, the evolution between Provoke and that second book that you're writing?
Very simple. Provoke is a collection of disjointed pieces.
Okay.
This one is a concept.
Oh.
It's still poems.
Okay.
Yes, it's all one story.
Okay.
It's all connected.
The whole thing.
Yes.
Does it have a title or is it something you can't
say? There is
a
working title, but I don't want to say it yet.
You can't say it, okay.
But you'll be the first to know,
okay,
for sure.
And when are we talking about? Release day?
Bardo, inshallah, around the same time the music. So probably after Eid.
Yeah. Okay, okay. But so obviously with everything not going on around,
yes,
as well. Okay.
It all depends on how everything is going.
Okay.
Out, yes.
And obviously when it comes to that, may I ask what was the thing that made you want to consider writing a book, like to publish that piece?
So 2019, 2020 were very definitive years for me. I served in the Egyptian military, and these were formative years for me. Yani, el sanatin dul, they changed my understanding of a lot of things, mostly about myself, how I feel, how I see the world. I've been wanting to reflect on that experience mentally بقالي فترة. In August 2023, I was moving jobs and I had some time. I realized, this is the perfect time to do it. So I sat down and I started sketching the first few ideas.
Wow.
And then from there, it just happened. And I've been writing it since.
Wow. But I think it's important to publish your work like that, like in terms of like, you know, books. I think it's super cool.
I think that's also something you don't know you need until you go through.
Mm.
Yani, my first experience was, I just got thrown in it. Yalla, let's publish.
Yeah.
Yalla, it was very coincidental.
Mm.
I was just, again, I have the best of people around me.
Yeah.
A very, very good friend of mine, Amani, she actually introduced me to Iman. And she's like, we're looking for, yalla.
Okay.
ورَبَّكَ الرَّزَّاقِ بقى.
I know.
ورَبَّكَ الرَّزَّاقِ.
But obviously with the second book, it's still obviously poems, but it's all one concept.
But there's a story, yes.
There's a story. Yes. Can we talk what the story is about? Or?
The story is, I cannot say too much, but I can tell you that there is a creature, and this creature goes through and meets two other creatures. It's three, there are three objects, but these three objects are animated.
Okay.
They come to life.
Okay.
Okay.
I love that. Also, when you work as a producer, like I know, shout out to Big Mo, for example.
Yeah,
you worked
of course,
a lot with
man.
Big Mo.
Of course, man.
And when you work as a producer, you started wanted to work with other people.
Yeah.
Now, for you, I'm sure you have, especially with Egypt right now, really like incredible.
Yes.
Do you have anything?
You kind of touched on it. Very nice.
Do you have anything? And like, are you working with some?
So last year, I released a song called Home Wrecker with an artist named Kiko.
Kiko.
Indie rock artist.
Okay.
Phenomenal artist.
Okay.
He's like the next wave of... He's bringing back indie rock.
Kiko,
you know?
How do you spell Kiko?
K-I-I-K-O.
K-I-I.
Kareem. Kareem is a phenomenal drummer, but then he decided to sing. At the time when he was preparing songs, I sent him a draft.
Okay.
I sent him a beat.
He What's the song called?
Homewrecker.
Okay.
And it's a part of his it's a part of his EP, his first EP.
Okay.
So that was the first effort as a producer
as
with
a producer.
Someone with someone outside my circle tamamen. Like someone I don't know very well, someone who's like... And then from there, I've always been making beats, but this year, I'm very close to this person.
Oh, wow.
I sent him like a bunch of beats, and every time I send him, he's like, I'm done.
He wrote on
done.
Wow.
And now we have an EP.
What?
We have a project. We have a full project that I've executively produced.
Wait, is this the record? I should make sure. Is this the record?
Yes, this is the record.
You
yes.
produced,
yes,
Kiko.
Yes, sir. We co-produced, yes.
Okay.
He added his own touch to it, of course.
Oh, no way. Can I hear a little bit of it?
Of course you
can. Is it radio friendly?
It is absolutely radio.
Okay, let's hear a little bit of it. This is Ziad Gadou. So he produced this record and he's working on production right now. It's a full EP you're working on.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And Kiko is Egyptian.
Yes, sir. Shout out to Kiko, man. He's doing great.
Yo, your song is playing on FM right now.
Let's go, bro. Shout out to the homies in Cairo.
Let's hear a little bit of it. You guys could produce this record. Ooh. I can't wait for the drop, right?
The drop is beautiful. You could have seen all the short films
and all the movies. Okay. I would have sung you all my hymns. What?
He's
Egyptian.
He's phenomenal. He's 21, 22.
What?
Very, very young, very, very talented.
And you know him from before?
Yeah, yeah, like online.
Okay.
We met the first time, like last month.
That's crazy.
An artist to keep an eye on. Absolutely.
Kiko.
His whole EP is phenomenal.
I can't wait.
I suggest you listen to Moods.
I'm definitely going to check.
I
but this is the record you produced.
Yes, sir.
I'm still waiting for that drop. Oh my God. Yes. I like that. So with this, shout out to Kiko, of course, with this EP that you're producing,
yes.
To produce an EP is also delicate. You're producing obviously 4-5 song or 3-4 songs.
Yes, yes, yes.
It's also like a big testament to the artist, a big deal for the artist to release an EP.
It's your responsibility create kind of like a consistent fabric throughout the project.
Exactly.
Yeah, it's not just on the vocalist or the rapper or the singer.
Yeah.
It's also, and now I'm taking a back seat and I'm letting him direct, but I'm also making sure that the car is moving in the same direction.
I was going to say that because I've spoken to so many producers along, obviously the past 10 years or so, and they always tell me there's always a big difference between producers and beat makers.
Oh.
And for you to be a producer, you need to direct. You need to speak. Criticize.
Of course. The last conversation we had, I was like, listen, I love what you did, but this beat needs something else.
That's a producer.
This beat needs a different presence.
Great. A beat maker wouldn't do that. A beat maker just does beats.
Beat ورايش.
Do whatever.
لا, that's especially okay. بس أحلى حاجة كمان when you're friends with this.
Yes.
When you're creating as friends, when you both have a vision, when you both are very passionate about what you do, you can't just let it kida pass.
So listen, you sold it to me, Rack. I'm super excited right now. He hadn't told me who the artist is. Do I know the artist?
I'm not going to say a word.
No, but do I know him?
I'm not going to say anything else.
Oh, okay. That means I do.
There you go.
Oh, my God. I swear, he hasn't told me. So Ziad is working on a new book, you guys.
Yes.
We don't know the name
yet.
So
the calendar is very busy this year.
Yeah.
We have two singles, inshallah.
Two singles.
We have one book. And we have an EP as a producer.
That's incredible. Man, that's incredible. That's amazing. Wishing you the best, really.
Thank you very much.
I want to say thank you so much. The time is really right now, but I really want to end with one more poem.
Yes.
If you don't mind. Or maybe two.
Yes.
I know that you obviously like to recite poems from people that inspired you. Tell me what you're going to recite.
So, when you told me that we're going to have this conversation, I just thought it was a good opportunity, obviously, to shed light on what's happening in Palestine and Sudan.
Of course.
And I contacted who better to tell the story than the people themselves.
Oh, wow.
So I reached out to some of my favorite poets. And one of my favorite Palestinian poets is Tariq Luthun.
Oh, Tariq Luthun.
An absolute icon.
Yeah.
I was obsessed with him when I started writing.
Yeah.
And to be able to read his piece with his permission, that's the big one, we spoke about it.
Shout out to Tariq.
And he's like, enjoy it, have fun. I also spoke to Qutuf Yahya, who's one of the first people I spoke to.
Wow.
And one of the first people I started performing with, like, in 2015. Yeah.
Wow.
So we have that, like, OG sort of feel, like, we know each other from way back. She did not hesitate to send me an unreleased chapbook.
Wow.
Like, it's a book that nobody knows about.
Wow.
That she hasn't released yet.
Wow.
I'm very, very honored.
Wow, shout out to her.
So I'm going to start with Khutuf's piece.
Okay.
And end with Tariq's piece.
Oh man, that's amazing. Please.
I hope I do them justice.
Oh, God bless. We're now listening, obviously, to Ziad Gadou. And the first piece is by Khutuf.
A Sudanese poet, yes,
okay.
Sir.
All right, shout out to her.
I learned from my father that a deep-rooted tree does not blossom. That is to say, I do not grow where I am from. I was not invited here, nor was I exiled. My flowers are a choice.
Ooh.
I have dug my palms in the earth before, and always they come empty.
Wow.
I was not invited here, nor was I exiled, but I cannot be thankful and call it love. That is to say, I cannot belong to that which does not belong to me. I was not invited here, nor was I exiled. And where I'm from, we do not leave. We rot in love. We build houses from hemp and mesh, so when the rain comes, we know to run. When the sunshine comes, we know to give thanks to the zinc for thudding louder than the brick that drowned us last time, to the water for staying out, to the children for learning that fear is not the storm, but every day it does not come. I was not invited here, nor was I exiled. And I know what a home is. And I only belong to myself. And that is to say, I only belong to that which will have me.
Wow. What, do you know when was this written?
I don't know anything, man. Like, I don't know anything about this book. All I know is that every piece I wrote, I drowned.
when you read that, that's incredible.
She told me, like, pick, and I picked this one because it felt like... You related to that. We were as expats, as people who've lived outside our countries.
Yeah,
you're like
the concept of home as well.
This is home. Like, yeah. It's an identity. It's a question of identity.
Yes,
but for Sudan right now, it's a circumstantial question of identity.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a question of identity you didn't want to have, aslan. You know, man.
That's I love that. I just wanna play a little bit of
Samadhi. Allah.
Just
the homie, Wallahi.
Yeah.
Wallahi, the
homie. What a guy, right? What a human being. Just, I mean, the briefcase for me, which is his obviously kind of beat tape.
Ugh. And actually, you played my favorite on the beat tape. Yeah. This is my favorite.
Oh, yeah?
Of
I love
course.
This one. I mean, we always play Samani and Sanos of Adiga right here on the show.
Shabab dol yani tislam alayhum.
Yeah. Seriously. Man. What the briefcase kind of represented for me was like it was an image to Sudan. And it was like how you want to discover Sudan through beats. This was the briefcase. What
bridging the generational gap.
Big time. Exactly.
But also, just on another level, Samani is a technically an incredible producer.
I agree.
الراجل ده بيعمل chops.
I agree.
بيعمل drums. Yeah. He did a drum for me for a series that I released last year called The 16s.
Wow.
And I sent him a raw melody. He sent me a song. Shukran.
Respect.
shout out to Samani for being the king that he is.
Of course. All right. To end the show, what are you going to recite for us?
I'm going to read Mismarked by Tariq Luthun. A piece.
Shout out to Tariq. Okay.
A piece that, to be honest, I watch when I don't know how to feel. Good luck. You're experiencing this for the first time.
Yes.
And I hope to God I do this justice.
Okay. Take it away.
We were born with eager feet. These bare boots too used to making the most of barriers and broken pavement. Wow. When I was 14, I spent the summer in Gaza, playing football in the garage with my cousins. Soccer served as a cliche metaphor for escaping. Often the ball would cross out of our makeshift stadiums and we would go get it. We built our rituals in retrieval, in returning, where I found bullets. Pitted in the porous cement walls of my late grandmother's home, I remember trying to dissect them for traces of hatred. Just so that I could know what gave them the audacity to fly so fast and so strong. So I tried to pry the steel from stone, with hands scarred and shaking like our doctors in bloody battlefield streets, trying to ply for life from the bony pincers of death. And all I could think was, how many? How many bullets? How many bodies? How many bullets have missed their marked bodies? I know of too many floating souls adrift in the woodwork of sonic booms and sandy shores in Palestine. Every day is a hurricane, a sandstorm of fists and lead. We lead with our fists first until we are fed. But look how they blame the hungry for swallowing their anger. As if the blockades were out of season. As if our boys had a choice between fight and flee. We scratch at the itch until we carve out the crazy. But where do you go when they straitjacket your city? When they peel away your borders to build asylums around you, there is nowhere to hide. Imagine having someone reach down your throat just to tickle your spine. Siphoning your history out of your soul to wave it before you like a bone. They treat us like dogs, canines barking in their kennels. If you look at a map, Gaza is a limb dangling from the body of the people. An anchor that cannot be trusted for all the wrong reasons. And I'm still trying to shed these shells. I'm tired of being shrapnel. A jagged casing of red-stained emotion, but there are no transfusions in a torn nation. No one donates pieces of themselves to the silenced. And here we are convinced that we are safe in our homes, in these beds that we not build ourselves. But when I wake up, I'm told who I belong to. I respond with a muted plea, a beggar's tune. My throat is a conglomeration of voices that are not my own, a box of blood and bile being channeled through a vessel that fills itself with the stories behind shattered screams, the holler of a trigger punch piercing through lung, shrapnel through the exoskeleton streets of a city that I used to wrap my backbone with. And all I'm left with are prayers that one day I can just go back, that my cousins and I will be those mist-marked bodies, not bodies in the mist-marked land.
Wow. That's heavy. That I was going to say something. Poetry, the way even you're saying it, how do I say this? It's like when you started saying it, I sink in. And when you stop, I go back to reality, right? Like to
I give you a break. I give you a break to breathe. Because I'm شخصيا مش بقدر
أفهم. No, this is crazy.
I need a moment to breathe.
Yeah, it's hard. And obviously as... Yeah, this is crazy. I think these poems being obviously told today on obviously Pulse 95 on the radio, I think it's really important. A lot of people are going to be inspired. If you're just tuning in and you love that, don't worry. You can check out the whole interview on YouTube and SoundCloud and all. Ziad, I got to ask you one more question.
Yes, sir.
We're way over time, but I got to ask you this.
Yes, sir.
What? How do you deal with the days that you think that you want to quit, you want to leave? Do you ever face those days?
Like,
what do you, how do you deal with those?
One, Rabbak Kareem.
Facts.
Brings peace into my heart somehow.
Okay.
Two, I have a family that sees in me what I don't see in myself.
Okay.
But my father believes that I am the president. He thinks I am the king of the world.
Allah.
That's the father I have.
Allah.
That's the mother I have.
What's his name?
Dr. Mu'taz Gadou.
Dr. Mu'taz Gadou, I remember. Yeah.
And I have friends that believe in the things that I do not see.
Okay.
Amazing. And part of being an artist is being delusional.
Mm.
And to quote J. Cole and to quote Musalim, yeah, we talked about this just the other day. Delusion is a big part of it.
Yeah.
Positive delusion, not like delusion in no,
I get it.
Positive delusion. The piece was in your mind before it came out.
Yeah.
I have proof of concept. I have 8 years. I have 9 years of proof of concept.
Yeah.
I've been an artist.
Mm.
I'm not. I am an artist.
Yeah.
That's the thing that reassures me.
But that belief in yourself is
that
really...
That took time.
I know.
That you are meeting Ziad 2.0, 3.0, yeah. 4.0.
Wow.
Fahim? Last time we met, this wasn't me.
Yeah. Where can people follow you? What's your social media, real quick?
Ziad Gadou on Instagram, at Ziad Gadou, ZIADGADOU.
Yeah, okay.
YouTube, Instagram, Kulil Kalanda.
And guys, he's releasing, obviously,
a new book.
Yeah,
my artist name is Gadou.
Gadou.
That is my artist name.
That's his artist name. And he's releasing a new book.
Yes,
he
sir.
He is releasing, obviously, an EP with a rapper.
Yes, sir.
He's releasing two singles.
Yes, sir.
And that's all coming up, obviously. And we want to play, definitely, these records. Any last thing you'd like to say, Ziad?
I want to say, please sit with who you are. Poetry allows you to. I'm not asking you to be a poet.
Mm.
That's not something I'm expecting of people. But poetry does a service. The service is for you to sit and ground yourself.
Mm.
Find the thing that grounds you.
I love that.
And don't let it hurt other people.
Mm.
Bas.
Oof.
Let's stop bleeding on each other.
Yes. Yeah. Thank you. Shukran with the way you said it. That's it.
Oh man. Khalas ya shabab, stay
there. Oh man. Ziad Gadou, go follow him, you guys. You have a record you want to end with? Anything in mind?
Soldier.
Okay. Which one?
Let's do Habsha.
Habsha.
Yeah.
Oh, I like this record.
Let's do Habsha.
Man, this guy's taste in music as well is amazing.
Let's do Soldier.
Ziad Gadou, thank you so much for being
on
Pulse 95 Radio.
Thank you very much.
Obviously, catch a vibe. We'll catch you guys tomorrow on the new episode. Peace and love. And we say, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Ziad.
Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thank you, sir.